It's fixture release day for the 2015-2016 Sky Bet Championship season, and it's been confirmed that Cardiff City will be kicking off their campaign here at home, and the team lining up in this tunnel against them will be Fulham. So let's take a look at the full fixture list. So Fulham first up and scheduled for Saturday the 8th of August, and last season's home fixture against the Cottagers was one that carries many fond memories for the City faithful, being the game at which we made the return back to blue. It was also 3 points for Cardiff City, with Sean Morrison earning us a 1-0 victory. And another interesting fact in there, Cardiff City haven't lost an opening home game since 2007. A midweek game in the Capital One Cup against Wimbledon then, before travelling to face QPR on Saturday the 15th of August, who were of course relegated from the Premier League last season. The last time City won at Loftus Road was back in 2010. Joe Ledley scored the only goal there, which sealed us a place in the playoffs. Staying on the road for a Tuesday night fixture on August the 18th, we're away to Blackburn Rovers, against whom we opened last season's Championship campaign. Cardiff City will then host Wolves on the 22nd of August, before seeing the month out away to Nottingham Forest, who were our final opponents of last season. City triumphant there with a 2-1 win, goals coming from Joe Ralls and Owen Doyle. September opens on the 12th due to the early international break, and we have two home games in 3 days, Huddersfield Town and the relegated Hull City. Then it's back to the New York Stadium, where the Bluebirds recorded their biggest away win of last season. Bruno Manga, Federico Makeda and Connor McElhenney scoring to record the 3-1 win. And we'll be looking to repeat that score on the 19th of September, before rounding the month off against Charlton Athletic at home on the 26th. Into October, the Bluebirds will face Brighton and Hove Albion before another international break, and resume with another away fixture to the newly promoted Preston North End on the 17th. Middlesbrough then at home before the seven-side derby returns, with Bristol City visiting the Welsh capital on the 24th of October. And the last time that happened, the Bluebirds managed a 2-1 win over the Robins. And October's schedule is rounded off with Ipswich Town away. We open November with a Tuesday night trip to Elland Road, where a low ticket allocation last season resulted in a fan boycott, but the boys did us proud nonetheless with a 2-1 win. Next up is Reading at home, followed by Derby away 2 weeks later. And then to round off November, Cardiff City Stadium will host the relegated Burnley. The last time we played the Clarets at home, the Bluebirds recorded a convincing 4-0 win. And then a very busy schedule for December, starting with Bolton away. Then a Saturday-Tuesday home double in the form of Sheffield Wednesday and Brentford. Then Birmingham City away, with one of the shortest trips of the campaign to St Andrews, before another trip on Boxing Day to League One runners-up MK Dons. And that's a nice 145-mile trip with a Christmas hangover. Enjoy, guys! And the final game of 2015 will be at home to Nottingham Forest, who were also the team that Russell Slade faced in his first game in charge of the Bluebirds, and that was a 2-1 home victory. Kicking off 2016, on the 2nd of January, the Bluebirds will face Blackburn Rovers at home, followed by the FA Cup third round. We're at the KC Stadium then on the 12th, and the last time that happened, Witt scored our only goal there to tie us at one apiece against the Tigers. Wolves away next on Saturday the 16th, who we last beat at Molyneux Stadium in February 2013. Back at home on the 23rd to welcome Rotherham before Huddersfield Town away as January's last game. MK Dons will visit Cardiff City Stadium for the first time on the 6th of February, starting off a 5-game alternating home-away stint throughout the month, with Charlton Athletic, Brighton and Hove Albion. Then our longest away trip of the campaign, a 590-mile round journey to Middlesbrough. And we round off the month with Preston North End's first visit to Cardiff since December 2011. Moving on to March, we're at Ashton Gate on Saturday the 5th for the second seven-side derby of the season. Cardiff City lost 4-2 last time we played them away, but their biggest win there came back in 2010 in a 6-0 thrashing with a goal from Witts, two from Ross McCormack, two from Michael Chopra, and topped off by an own goal. And then another big game for City when Leeds United come to Cardiff City Stadium. And it was against the Whites that Bruno Manga scored his first goal for the Bluebirds in a 3-1 win last season. On Saturday the 12th then, at home again against Ipswich, against whom Witts scored this screamer in this fixture last season. Finally, we have Reading away for the last game of March. April opens with Derby at home before a Tuesday night trip to Burnley. And of course, Turf Moor is where City sealed the Championship title back in 2013. Staying on the road, we are at Craven Cottage on Saturday the 9th. And a week later, we welcome QPR. The last time the Hoops were here, the scores ended with a 2-2 tie. Craig Bellamy and Jay Bothroyd on the score sheet for City. Brentford away then on Tuesday the 19th, the fixture last season at which Alex Ravel scored this goal that took goal of the season at the Supporters Trust's award evening. Bolton at home on the 23rd, Sheffield Wednesday away on the 30th of April in our penultimate game of the season, before we close against Birmingham City at Cardiff City Stadium on the 7th of May. The last time the Blues came to the Welsh capital, we managed a 2-0 win. And that concludes the full 2015-2016 Sky Bet Championship fixtures. Dates are subject to change, but you can find the full details on our website.